Welcome to Rebel Love Show. We are a once-a-week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire, where we are pro-pot, pro-gun, and pro-coffee. You can find all of our contents at rebelloveshow.com. I am Rob Mathias.
And I am the Rebel Mistress. And we're here with our lovely guest, Twila.
What's up?
Is that your name now? Can you just make that official?
I think you just made it official, just at this moment.
At this moment, Rob? At this moment. Twizzla? You're gonna be like this great liberty activist and you don't even know it yet. So
yeah, pretty much.
your liberty name is Twizzla.
No pressure.
So before we get into the good stuff, I guess ask everyone, how was your weekend? Because last weekend wasn't convention, even though this is our convention recap episode. We had the
We take the first every month for the new movers party, so it's been since we've had like an actual broadcast, and a shit ton has happened in the last 2 weeks. Like, I feel like I've lived like 2 months since the last time I've been on the air.
I asked the question, how was your weekend, and I don't even remember my weekend. Yeah, like, what year is it?
Where are we? I don't really know. I kind of remember Keenvention, but this past weekend, I don't know.
This something's past happened, weekend was just like the recovery from Keenvention, yeah. I think.
Was it? Oh my god.
I quit my
weekend.
Job.
A lot happened this weekend. What are you talking about?
That
like,
was
so
Monday.
Much happened.
Wait, was that this weekend?
Well, I mean, we actually have show notes for this kind of stuff. That, I mean, besides Keenvention, we're going to dive down deep if you can even remember Keenvention. New Movers Party happened. There was the whole Shire Sharing comedy event that was going down. All the Uber activism that was going on in Portsmouth. I mean, that's just kind of tipping the iceberg, but that's a lot
Uber
of stuff.
Is activism like right to travel? I always wondered that.
No.
It's like
right,
driving
right to
license.
Travel. I guess it is.
Right to give people rights.
I suppose it is probably a version of like a right to travel activism, but taken to a completely different perspective. Usually right to travel activists are usually about like, I don't need an ID to ride on those roads, on these roads. Like I'm a free human being to travel anywhere. Uber activism is kind of similar. It's just not asking permission to use an app to drive drunk people around. So I suppose it's kind of like right to travel activism, but it's not really. And it's more of civil disobedience than right to travel activism.
Well, it's in that field. But was Uber this weekend? That was Sunday?
That was Friday
night. That was Friday.
That was Friday.
Oh, okay. That's why I don't remember the weekend. Okay, so I guess we should just start with convention. This was our 1 year anniversary. Me and Tila's 1 year anniversary as well.
1 year.
1 year. Yeah. It feels like a lifetime.
I know. I feel like I've known you for like millions of years, but only 1 year.
It's been at least like 5 Shire years since you've appeared into the world.
World. I was going to say.
I was so excited to go to convention last year because I was branching into the community and I had already met people from Keene, but I didn't really know anyone at that time. My roommates, and then Tila was my roommate. And that just, she was someone's girlfriend at the time. So I was like, who is this bimbo? He's going to be sleeping in our room. And then we just became good friends after that. And then, of course, me and Rob got back together. And then this year,
on the dance floor at the Hollow King
dance
party last year.
And then this year, I was actually on panels, which I found very surprising. Because to come to convention just as a newbie last year and then be on multiple panels this year, it just is a testament to how much you can get done after you move here.
I think you've risen, Anne. Like, you've risen from, like, coming into the community
she,
to, like, super famous. Like,
you know, you want to know why, right?
She's awesome.
Oh, besides the fact that she's awesome. I mean,
that's obviously.
I mean,
it.
My real mistress here is more than awesome. She's
gonna say it's because I'm black. Watch.
No. It has nothing to do with the fact that you're black. It has nothing to do with that. It's the fact that you made it past the casting couch at the old Rebel Love Studios.
Oh, shut your mouth.
That is the reason why you have risen. you made it past the casting phase.
You're
into the...
absolutely ridiculous. But anyway, so I think my favorite panel out of all the panels, and not because Rob was on it, he was my least favorite person on all the panels. I'm just kidding. My favorite panel had to be the tech panel. Was very inspirational. I heard Stephanie Murphy. She was telling this story. She started off her career, and she was in chemistry, working in a lab, and that she really wasn't happy, and you know, she thought maybe if she could just work from home, that would make her happier. And then she kind of had this realization that she could do her job from a basement, but, like, that wouldn't make her any happier. And I was kind of having that same dilemma in my life. I was like, well, you know, I could do my job. I could find a job just like my job and do that job from home. But, you know, I don't want to be doing chemistry in a basement. It was my chemistry as hers. Like, I want to be doing something else and something different. So she kind of turned me on to voice acting. So I pursued that, and I actually got my first audiobook deal. So I actually just finished it today. So that'll be coming out soon.
We have the equipment. We might as well actually make some goddamn money off of this shit.
Exactly. So that was my kind of Keenvention miracle, I think. It gave me some balls and courage. So did you guys have a favorite panel or Keenvention miracle?
Keenvention miracle is just celebrating our 1 year, back together for me.
Aww.
I don't know if that's a convention miracle, but I'm still celebrating last year's convention miracle.
I think that you can't, like, you can't piggyback.
Okay. Well,
separate things, right?
Yeah. For me, let me see here. Panel wise, God, I did so many panels. The Cop Lock, I love the Cop Lock panel just because that was the first panel that me and you ever did together. So it was kind of like the Rebel Love Show did a Cop Lock panel, which is pretty cool. I enjoyed that. I enjoyed the sedition, secession panel that I moderated.
You're gonna say the sedition sirens last show?
Yeah, the last show. We need to come back. That's like that's like too much to even go into before the commercial break. Panel, you are. Was the best panel. I had the best back and forth. Brian Sovereign was awesome at it.
He is.
Stephanie Murphy was awesome on that panel. I was awesome on that panel. and I got up early,
Shameless
too. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
I can't believe you all made it.
9 o'clock in the morning.
I sleepwalked there.
And that was after the Keenvention the Halloween dance party. I mean, that
was crazy. Okay, Tilo, your Keenvention special panel or
I just have to agree with you that my favorite panel had to be the tech panel. I mean, Brian was great moderating and everybody was talking. I don't think it was really anything revolutionary, but it was like,
Mine was just like personal revolution.
Yeah. I saw a few panels and I enjoyed them, but it was nothing like, oh my gosh, this is awesome. The Cop Block panel was kind of interesting. I'd never heard JP talk before or didn't really know who he was.
I didn't know him. Much better in the last 2 weeks. Because in all honesty, like, I've kind of allowed to internet rumors and posts and Keniac posts and stuff like that to really sully like my view of him.
Yeah.
And I've got to talk to him at convention. I got to talk to him during the ports. Oh my God. We go into the whole Uber Cop Block.
We'll go into that later.
Yes. Back to the next commercial break. Maybe we'll touch that at some point. But yeah, he's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's really cool. I'll save it for later. I love the photo I got of him.
I guess it's unanimous that the tech panel had to be the best panel then. And also the panel where that girl threw up was pretty good.
That was the tech panel.
That was the tech panel.
Yeah, that was the tech panel.
See, it was so apparently when you party hard at convention, sometimes you get hungover.
Why that person threw up was because Dennis Goddard was out there talking. So I mean,
shots fired.
My apologies, Dennis. You're probably not listening, anyways. That wasn't the reason. But.
Yeah, no, he was saying some stuff that was vomitable.
I think that person threw up when he started going off on anarchy and talking about how Bitcoin needs to be used for like government institutions or something crazy along those lines. Yeah, and that's when that person threw up.
No, they should collect our taxes in Bitcoin.
Yeah, he said that would be a win for us. Bitcoin. I was like, How is that a win at all?
You just made Bitcoin obsolete for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, the whole purpose of Bitcoin is to have it outside of the monetary system, not within it.
Well, we didn't even get through everything, so more when we come back. Hopefully more organized.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government...
Hey, Tila, can you actually...
Yeah,
No, you're fine talking. lower your chair.
And can veto most bad bills.
Let's just sink it down. And I'm trying to fix like the chroma key on yours.
Sign the pledge at Free State Project.
You got there? Right, a little bit farther.
These things have wait, you're good. Your tits need to be in the camera.
Yeah. You have a really tall neck. That's your problem. That's not a problem. It's a great thing, but.
A little bit lower?
You're good. Oh, wow, the chroma key's all jacked up on that.
Yeah, but perf. You're okay. Perf.
Whew. Stay close. Lean forward.
That's, okay, wait.
It was good, and then you messed it up. Oh, my God.
That's actually worse.
Is this the camera right here in front?
I don't.
It's not you. It's the chroma key.
I
realize you may feel
differently, but my relationship. I can move.
No, don't move. Okay. Don't fucking move. If Starbucks
used some of its money to drop bombs. There you go. No. No, it was there. I swear. And then you moved it. And then it wasn't there anymore. No. I think you need to actually.
So what if I, like. Out, go back in.
The lights are all bad today.
It's because I changed that light.
Yeah, that light's way bright. I mean, that's what it is. Tila's so white, that light's so bright.
I'm white in general.
Yeah. It's like shining through you. Anytime on your smartphone or tablet, just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN. Oh, do you have my quoted thing? Because I want to read it.
Your what? No, get that up on your end. And let your
family know. How does this work?
Hold on. Look, I actually took off the shot so I can actually edit it. Being on the shot. I was listening at home on
the interweb. Do you have any days off of training? Or
weekends.
Monday through Friday.
Monday through Friday.
Chroma key is really hard to do sometimes.
And then I've got plans this weekend. And
what are you doing this weekend?
Going home. Visit my niece and nephew.
Oh, yeah. I miss you.
But I'll be back Saturday night for the party. So.
What party? Oh.
Blake's.
Mm-hmm. Blake's going to the party. And, of course, Sunday for your thing. So. I feel like I'm jiggling the table.
I'm excited about Sunday.
I am, too.
Even if I don't find a dress, I get a, like $100 off someone else's dress. So
right, and it's just like it's your first kind of like
fitting.
It's like getting into it, you know.
Yeah, I'm excited. Okay, can I just say when we talk about my article in convention, how everyone's picture made it on there except me?
Yeah, quote an article.
But they couldn't. Even
that's
because
you're black, babe.
Listening, you can also watch. I'll bring it back in with this. Radio Network's key New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at
cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network. What is with that?
I'm still waiting. Oh, there you go.
That's good. Listen, watch, and okay.
Wait, see the move?
Wait, no, hold on. I'll go.
There you go.
Awesome.
Yeah.
No. Go back
no.
to where you were.
You're fine.
I already got the shot lined up for that side.
You're like the.
Look, it takes
so much. Guys.
The green screen was shining through your teeth whenever you opened your.
Yeah,
mouth.
So it was like you saw our logo coming out of your teeth. It was really weird.
Oh my God.
But it's fixed now, so yeah, don't worry about it. Just to watch the first segment on YouTube, and you'll be fine.
Now you're fine.
All right. For more tips like these, visit
us at parenthood.com/. You know, it takes a lot to actually get this is the Liberty up and running. Network. I'm right here to break. I think I need to have a show clock, which I don't have the show clock. I keep wanting to like. And we are back, guys, with the Rebel Love Show. We got Tila here sitting as our new guest tonight. And we're recapping Keenvention.
I was bringing it back, but Rob.
You're bringing it back. I always forget. Did I overcut you?
Yeah.
Usually we do it where I bring it back and you bring it back. Usually
you
turns.
Brought it back first.
No, so I brought it first.
You brought it?
Yeah,
it's
I brought
already
it.
Already been brought in. Okay, Keenvention draws libertarian activists, which was an article written. I haven't seen any other articles about Keenvention, so I'm going to say this is the most important one about the ladies panel, which it was quoted mostly.
And where was this quoted at, babe?
This was quoted at the Union Leader. You can find this at unionleader.com/Keenvention. Draws libertarian activists, and it'll come up. So the Keen liberty activists flocked to the third annual Keen. Did you know this was only the third one? I thought it was like the fourth or the fifth one. I didn't know it was just
the third one. It's still a newbie conference, to be honest.
Do you think it's the last one?
I hope not. I hope.
Keen's slowly dying.
Keen's dead.
I hate to say it.
Like the CAC more? That was
no, the CAC is there. It's called the slap.
Okay. Anyway, we already had a show about this. And it said they brought the female perspective, which is obviously important for the Union Leader. Thank you very much,
Speaking
Rob.
Of, for those that are listening outside of New Hampshire, the Union Leader is kind of like the New York Post or Chicago Tribune of New Hampshire. It's like one of the major newspapers here.
Oh, yep. So Katie McCall of Stone Manor, Ellen of Puke in the Gang podcast, which isn't necessarily.
No, she's on that long enough to be recognized as part of that.
I mean, she's
show.
Done other things.
Yeah, okay. I know. They didn't quote her as being on the Rebel Love show. Yeah. Not that they actually quoted you of being on the Rebel
Love
show.
Yeah, they said Anne Leverett of Seditious Sirens, which if you haven't heard by now, the ladies panel was the last episode of Seditious Sirens. The Seditious Sirens are no more.
Thank you.
Me and Renee are still friends, so you can show drama mouths. Anywho, so we mostly talked about our experiences of coming to the Free State Project, and I, with my magical brilliance, was quoted. Thank God I said something because I was high. According to the website, the Free State Project is at 88% of its goal. When it reaches 20,000, any participants who haven't already moved to New Hampshire are excited to make the move. The panel was asked where they expect the movement to be in the next 5 years. And the women said they expect the goal to be reached and the move to be triggered. And quoting the Rebel Mistress, they said, I think we're at 88% on the way to 20,000. So in 5 years, I think we'll be at our goal and I think we'll be triggering the move. We've seen new kinds of activism. We're standing up more than ever to the state because we are greater in numbers. People think that sometimes the liberty movement is dying, and that's not what I'm seeing. I'm seeing it thrive. And I think that was a great quote.
Wow, they really quoted you.
They really did.
Like, they went into depth.
Because they like what I'm saying here. They're picking up what I'm putting down, if you know what I'm saying. But anyway, I feel like that was definitely solidified with the New Movers Party. Because that new movers party was
there
huge.
Was like 100 people. Yeah. There's 17 new movers. 17. One new movers party. It's so like that 17 is like a new movers party in itself. Just that many people being there.
I think they used five families is what they said. So.
Yeah, that was incredible.
The family, I love how they came away too. Like, you know, because family is important. And I've seen people from was crazy. I never seen it so big. I feel like they should do more, what can I say? Like they tried to do a slideshow and a big presentation for this one, which is kind of funny because it was just so many people. Maybe
I find it funny that they're trying to they're actually going, putting some sort of effort into what's what I'm looking for? In doing an initiation for new movers, this is what this is.
Yeah.
This is going out over here. Make sure you go and like this on Facebook, blah, blah, blah. Go in this group. Right. You know, there's this, they have a little tiny calendar of events that's coming on,
that's going on next week. That needs to happen. As we saw with the Uber activism, which we won't completely get into but there were people there. We were standing there protesting, and there were people there who are part of the Free State Project. They had moved a month or so ago, and they didn't even know any of this is going on. They just came down here to flick the bar off.
You want to know why? Because there's way too many goddamn libertarian anarchists in this movement that don't even want to be on Facebook, that somehow discover this via not Facebook. And I hate Facebook too, don't get me wrong. You have to be on there.
Yeah.
There is no if and or buts. If you leave it, you are not in. You're not tied into the community. You don't know what's going on. You know, unless you have that social network already in place somehow, somewhere within it. But in all honesty, if you don't join multiple different Facebook groups and add a bunch of people, you won't get invites to things that are going on. You won't know what's going on in the community.
That's how all the events are worked. What am I doing today? Oh, I've got five different
five or six
events.
Different Facebook.
Which one am I going to tonight? Like, Without Facebook, I wouldn't be able to connect with anybody, I think. I mean, it's so hard.
Just for the calendar of events, just the events coming forward, what's happening, that's the biggest reason that you need to be on Facebook. Now, mind you, if you are somehow listening to this, not on Facebook, and you're like, you know, fuck Rob and Ann Teela for saying be on Facebook, I'm not going to give Big Brother anything, you know, if that is the case...
People are like advertising like liberty.me and everything, and that's fine, but no one's on that. So how is that going to be beneficial?
Chris Lopez actually does do NH Liberty Calendar. I think it's nhlibertycalendar.org or
yes.
.com. Or
I think it's .org.
I don't check it because I'm on Facebook, but if I was on Facebook, I actually would check that out. That actually is a really good thing. Patrick Binder from out in California, you know Patrick Amari.
Yeah.
Patrick actually has a great website. It's liberty.menu, but I don't think it's actually... a lot of people post to it. It's like this whole idea of having Liberty businesses and calendar and events and stuff like that. So you can just go to your neighborhood and like see what's going on.
Yeah.
It's really cool, but actually, I don't know how many people actually...
He actually started news alerts like through YouTube. So he'll send you like this alert and it'll just tell you like an update of all businesses and agris vendors, which I thought was really cool because he sent me the link and I clicked on it and I was like, that is more realistic than me going to liberty.menu.
Yeah.
It's really cool. It's just, I mean, at the end of the day, this shit's really niche.
Yeah.
Like even like I understand we act as if like we're like the we are like the shit. This is like the world. You know, why is everyone else following what we're doing? But at the end of the day, this is niche.
So many of us.
Babe, you have a bullet point labeled drugs and anarchy. I just wanted to see where you were going with that.
Where I was going with that? Well, that was referring to Keenvention.
I think like, that's up.
How much sex, drugs, and anarchy happened there?
Oh, my God.
The whole weekend.
If you're Cody O'Connor, if you're listening to this, you would appreciate it.
First off, Cody fucking Connor of Off the Air Live. Why the hell were you not at Keenvention? You missed a great dance party. He's not lame. He just needs to get out of Portland for once.
Only time we see him is if we go there and harass him.
I know.
And we
do a good job of
count.
Harassing him, too. Like, we harass the shit out of him on Off the Air Live.
But anyway, Cody, if you're listening to this, you'll appreciate it. I tweaked so hard at the Halloween dance party. We'll tell you what our costumes were when we come back. Maybe we'll put up a picture for the people watching.
Maybe.
Free Press Publications, an independent alternative
dance party's in there,
it's
right there, babe.
Publishing company founded in
we haven't even smoked pot yet.
I know. Wow.
Oh, the house. The freedom movement. Yes, I wish I could. I'm not going to do it now. You are so right. I can download it. Wait. Let me see if I. Babe, don't drop the pot, baby.
Sorry,
guys, don't you drop the pot.
It's so hot in here.
It's the lighting.
I feel like I'm in a sauna.
Well, this is a clothes optional.
Saunas.
Oh, my God. Yeah, you missed the sauna.
I know.
And weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com.
Way too many guys. There need to be a couple other women to make that an orgy. Yeah, there's maybe if you were there, it could have been like an orgy, but like the ratio need there need to be a ratio.
Yeah.
At least like.
That's true.
Yeah.
Free Talk Live, we're bringing to the idea. From superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe, like I said.
Oh, I can just went to Johnson Rice's video. What am I doing? I want to try and download the video and throw it in the background.
Oh my God, that'd be awesome.
That's the goal here.
Issues years ago.
Whoa, sorry. In on the radio. I went to go, I went to it and didn't have it muted. Oh, this is a good one. Is this where we're spanking Derek Jay's ass?
And become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why.
Was there only one? I mean, I saw the one in the video where I'm doing some weird matrixy move.
I know, it was awesome.
I was like, what was I doing?
Your amp will directly change more lives by
getting free talk. Me? Oh, yeah, I've seen that one. I'm just doing this.
Online and on the air.
That's all I'm doing.
All right, it is downloaded. Sweet. Podcast. Visit Cider in the bong.
She's doing it.
This is your Robertson.
Are you serious, babe? Don't fuck up that. Early trading Tuesday, gold is off. All right, I'm adding a video shot here. Let's see if I can actually pull this off. $14.42 per ounce. Trading at $359. You know, I would love to pay someone to do this, what I'm doing right now, but I don't have the money. What do you want in payment?
Buy online and support peace at
our. Well, first off, you got to prove the fact that you can do this.
874-9760.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are: 1. Let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2. Buy the things you buy online from shop.lrn.fm. 3. Give $5 a month to the program at LRN.FM. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon, online. You can get what at the same great prices, and LRN gets. Please online shop.lrn.
Yeah.
Once in a while, you get information that changing for 179. You can save and be 25% on all prices at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought about it.
There we go.
Know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to savethepurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin.
7.
I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% of on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way. Savethepurse.com right now. Get and catch a huge I'm on you. 5% off everything at Amazon. Purse.com. It's savethatpurse.com.
Make that number 8.
You can receive the latest about
there
the
we go.
Radio
oh, that looks awesome. Look at that.
Updates.
I love how you look. There you go. Just dance for a little bit, Tila.
Updates. FM.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Rob has just decided it's the crazy dance video from the Halloween dance party. Looks awesome, and it was awesome. Not that I can really remember it.
Well, just to jump in, if you are listening to LRN.FM or IPM Nation, you listen to us live on those stations, go to rebelloveshow.com, click on live right there in the navigation bar, and you can watch our beautiful faces from our studio cams, and yes.
And you can see the Halloween dance party
playing yes, go
behind
and play
us,
behind us, which is
background.
Pretty badass looking, I won't lie.
Okay, so I mean, this Halloween is nothing like last Halloween, but both I don't really remember.
It's hard to remember good times sometimes.
Like, I know last convention I only did illegal drugs, so I was, like, drunk as fuck, and I ended up, like, vomiting. Like,
you were, like, passed out that, yeah. by the time
unfortunately,
we got back to the
that room. Was that after or before? No, that was after.
That was after.
Together.
That was after.
I hope, that's
up.
Not, I hope that wasn't a,
that was,
a result.
It was a drunken mistake.
Oh, my God. It's like a whole year of a lie.
Yeah.
It's like 3 Shire years of lies, babe.
Drunken mistake. Hooked up with my ex. And I was like, Tila, I hooked up with Rob.
I know. The next morning. Well, the next morning I was like, Anne, what happened to you last night?
And I was like, Jesus. And I just can't mention what happened because I don't know. Okay, so we went as like 20s. 20s. And you went as, what did you go as?
I went as a character from a UK TV show that no one's ever heard of.
But Skins.
Skins.
Well, regardless.
Todd. I've
Thank
heard
you.
Of it.
I love it.
Yeah, you looked hot. I went as like mobster. I had like this blonde wig. And this is so funny because someone commented a picture we posted because they had convention the dance party somewhere different this year. We had to travel, which kind of made it hard. I think it. I don't know if as many people attended, but maybe that's why, because people had to drive there and people were worrying about getting drunk. But luckily, we had a DD, so we went there just ready to get as fucked up as possible.
I will say this. I didn't like the fact that the Halloween dance party was in the hotel like it was last year. However,
it lasted like an extra hour and a half, two hours,
which was fantastic. And there was a fog machine. Yeah. It was a bigger area.
That's true.
Oh, the fog machine was great.
Yeah.
But anyway, so someone commented on one of the pictures that the ladies originally was giving him a hard time. Like, that they he thought, like, the Elks Lodge people were going to be dicks. But then when we came there...
They were great.
It would help the fact that we were rolling when we got in there.
It was just no way they could be mean to us. We were just like, I was just like, oh, hey, like, you want to dance? Like, what's up? I gave the owner my wig. She ended up wearing it for the rest of the night and dancing with us, and she was just having a great time. And they were like, thank you guys for showing up and, like, turning her frown upside down.
You know, there was pictures in my camera, which I don't even remember, but of us taking photos with her. And I don't really remember taking those photos. I'm like, what the fuck? Why would we have pictures? Who is this woman wearing this blonde wig? And why am I having a picture next to her? Like, I don't understand what's going on, you know? But, man, I love that party.
That was such a good party.
That was such a fun party. I love the fact that, like, the laser light show from that party was the same Domenico laser light show from the big gay dance party.
It was epic. Yes. I remember being super drunk and just being like, oh my gosh, these lights are just so cool.
Tia, imagine if your second hit of MDMA at like 9 o'clock and like the laser light and the music, like everything kind of just like blended together. And just seeing so many different great costumes at the same time.
There's great ones.
Oh, and I emceed.
And yeah, my real mistress here did emcee the party. Hopefully that gave her some gumption to take over the bigger and better parties to come. I don't know if we're keeping that down low. But yeah, she emceed. She didn't let me win the best costume.
No. You know, she thought it would be favoritism. You know?
Yeah.
Wait, what did you say?
Yeah, I know. Favoritism. You didn't let me win the best costume. I will say this. You
like,
did
you
do
did
a great job.
The best costume.
I know I didn't. But I did have decent dance moves. So I appreciate you giving me the tie on that. The costume contest ended up basically, Derek J was in the running. Sorry, Derek J, as great as your ass looked as an Asian woman, it wasn't the key. But both Daniel being Ian Freeman from the big gay dance party, which was so inside niche costume.
But it was so great.
I was rooting for him. I really was rooting for him. Renee being the corpse bride, she did put a lot of fucking effort into that. And in all honesty, I didn't think she should win. But her performance to prove the fact that it was a better costume, her dance, the fist pump of her hair, the throwing it down, like she won
she
because
took
of
off,
that.
She took off her wig and threw it at Daniel.
She did. There's pictures.
She threw it at him. Fucking shit. You know what? She did build her costume
from
scratch.
Yeah.
And people at like at Keene, they had what is the thing that they had? Social Sunday at Keene. I heard they were talking about how I rigged it. But no, I don't even like Renee. Like I don't even like her. Like I
no,
wouldn't
that wasn't rigged.
I wouldn't
that
have just given it to her. But I did see her make her whole costume from scratch, and that was a good costume. And the makeup
really
like was really good.
It was perfect.
And she threw off her wig to win, like I had to give it to her. And I did the costume. Like, I made people cheer. I did it by most, like, round of applause.
Oh, yeah. You did a great job emceeing that.
I emceed the shit out of that.
It's a good thing you
Halloween.
Were there. Yeah.
No, I was hoping, which, I mean, I guess I should pose the question to the gay anarchist, which I guess I eventually will. Maybe I will this Thursday on Flaming Freedom. You know, I think that maybe since there will be no Buzz's Big Gay Dance Party, they should do a Gay Anarchist Big Gay BDSM Party.
Just a Big Gay Dance Party.
Yeah.
No.
Big Gay Dance Party
They should
has
call
to,
it
no,
Gay Anarchist Big Gay
no,
Dance Party.
No, you can change the name of who is actually doing the party.
Okay.
But you can't change the name of the party. I'm not saying that. I want it to be as fucking kinky and BDSM as possible at this Big Gay Dance Party. I ain't saying that's not the case. I'm just simply saying you can't change the actual name of it. You can change who's hosting it, but not what the name of the actual party is. It's so much tradition in that party that you cannot change the name. If you change the name, it's not the same party anymore.
Okay, whatever. So, Gay Anarchist Big Gay Dance Party, whatever.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah, no, I think that would be fun. And in that way, the responsibility is not on one person, but it's a big gay party planners. So, yeah. I mean, I feel like those guys would be equipped for the job.
Well, that's not actually out.
Oh, and the gays were out. At the convention dance party, I feel like we were large in numbers. We took a great group photo. Derek was a hot bitch.
Oh my god,
that was the first time I actually got to meet Joe Jarvis.
Oh, me too.
I never met him before.
Me either. And
I know he's at Porkfest. I never actually got a chance to talk to him.
I've never met Joe, and I've done like multiple shows with him. Like once Flaming Freedom went down, and we did the show just us two. I love Joe, so it was great getting to meet him. And taking a picture with him. Everyone's so great. I didn't know you could build like close friendships with people you just do podcasts with, but apparently that's possible.
You can. Yeah, you really, really
can. Yeah, he's great. And I miss him. He just moved to Florida.
I don't know what the fuck he's thinking.
I think he's just doing like a road trip. He wants to try being a farmer.
You could be a farmer here.
Yeah, be a
That's what I said.
Well, I know he says he wants to get to the point where he has half his life up in New Hampshire during the summer and the other half down in the winter.
That's
the
life.
Goal of everyone.
I
don't want to be
goal.
Here January and February.
Yeah, I know.
Winter is coming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the dance party was definitely a lot. It was more fun. I stayed longer, and, you know, I wasn't drunk as fuck.
Yeah.
It's funny how the legal drugs can get you like so fucking
illegal drugs are so much more funner.
I can dance so much better all night. Like, I swear, I walked into the party, I blinked twice, and it was over.
It did happen really quickly.
I was actually talking with somebody on the sidelines, and I was just like, how are these people still dancing? Like, and they're like, oh, they're definitely on something. That's why they're dancing still. Like, the rest of us are, like, tired and, like, ready to go home, and, like, everybody was on illegal drugs was, like, still just dancing like crazy.
Well, yeah, that give you... Yeah, when you're rolling, you have so much energy.
Yeah, I just remember Derek coming over and saying, hey, what, the last song? Come on. And just danced it out. Okay, let's talk about the new movers party a bit more when we come back and share sharing.
Dance it out, babe.
Money, power, and
party file.
I know, I can't. Oh, I was so scared that you spilled that on the laptop. I'm like, holy
that
fuck.
That was a really good cover. I was just like, he's not freaking out. He's staying calm.
That was on live radio that she spilled a drink. Like, literally, it splashed. I got the computer. I'm
all
like,
over. It didn't splash on the computer. This is like actually the third time.
I thought I was pretty pro. Like, just act as if it didn't even happen. Just like looking at you, like talking, like, you know, all right. Like, spilled a drink all over thing. Speaking of, can you put more drinky in my drink and more pot in the bowl?
I can do the more pot in the bowl thing. This is probably going to be disgusting.
Yeah, you mix it with the beer.
Ew.
You mix the cider with the chocolate beer. What the fuck are you doing?
Did she just chug it?
No, there wasn't that much chocolate in there. Okay. It was a very little amount. We haven't even been paying attention to the chat. Are you a political activist who does what the fuck is going on with it? What's going on in the chat? The slap. What the fuck? Cactus to slap. Slap. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, the name sucks, dude. I'm well aware.
Slap him and heat him. Wait, go back up. What is this conversation?
Oh, it's when we started talking about the cat. Download
Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com.
That's rats. Oh, what does SLAP or SLAC stand for? SLAP stands for Society of Love and Peace, or I don't know. It's something like that.
Something like that. Plus, you can stay in the loop by
joining our Facebook profile. All right, am I bringing it back or are you bringing it? Or follow us at Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm. It's all free. So sign up now at
updates.lrn.fm for news updates delivered to your email box. Facebook page. Yeah.
Twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets. Coming out to everyone.
Understanding your credit score. You guys want to do a Snapchat video?
And improving yeah, we should Charlie be snapping Sundstrom this.
With your right. Van Dyke mortgage. I want to hit record.
The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts.
Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've used. Well, this is because you spilled it all over the studio.
Well, I tried to pour cider in there.
to help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score. Have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit.
I got a great idea for a video.
Never close old accounts.
First,
actually, your credit score.
Recording the screen.
Don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna post that to like local New Hampshire.
Okay.
I'm gonna put Manch Vegas at the top.
Imagine someone in your community getting in their car, turning on the radio, and hearing the Liberty Radio Network. You can make that vision a reality with your own micro radio station. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how you can put our programs on the air in your area. You can have lrn.fm running around the clock, and you can even add in your own local shows. Building a radio station is simple, but programming isn't. That's where lrn.fm comes in.
Oh yeah, I did bring it in.
Broadcast.lrn.fm. That's broadcast.lrn.fm.
Yeah, I figured he got it back then, but
Oof. I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State. Or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
What's going on?
Do you want
to
see it?
Say hi to
who?
What's up? What's up, Brian?
Yo.
To join the chat on
Welcome back to the Rebel Love Show, and we're talking about Keenvention, but I kind of want to talk about what happened once we got back from Keenvention. We came back, and we came back to this new movers party. For those that haven't moved yet, here in Manch Vegas in the Shire, there's a new movers party the first Tuesday of every month. It's always like 7, so whatever. It's at the Quill. There is at least like 100 some people. There were 17 new movers, 15 families. Like me and Ann, we walk in there like at 7:30, something like that, and we literally couldn't even get in the door. That's like how big were there.
It's usually a potluck, so I wish this time, because usually we try to bring something like, and usually it's like a fruit platter or something like that. And this time I think we just brought beer, like 2 cases, and that was like not enough. And I was like, we should have brought beer and food and everything else this time. And I was just like really disappointed. And I felt like this was a great time to see such a heartbeat in the Liberty movement, because people have been saying like, you know, they don't see good things happening with Keen or activists coming here anymore, but that's not true. And we saw that, like, with our own eyes at the new movers party.
Every month there's been a lot of new movers. Like, these new movers parties, especially in the last 6 months, keep building and building bigger and bigger. I've definitely witnessed. I remember my first new movers party when I was here. There was maybe 17 people there. Like, there was, like, nobody there at that new movers party. Like, it wasn't advertised. There wasn't, like, that many new movers. I was, like, one of 4 other new movers.
Now you can be in a room full of people you don't even know. Yeah. Look, and you've been here for a year.
It is, from someone, I mean, neither of us here are OG Freestaters. I mean, Tila's only been here for 1 Shire year. Ann's only been here for, like, 4 or 5 Shire years. Hell, I've only been here for, like, 8 Shire years. So, like, it's not like we've all been here that long.
I haven't even been here for a year.
Yeah, like your move date's not for another month. So I'm saying this from I've been to every new movers party since I moved here, which was January back in 2014, and I've never seen that many new movers at one time. There's moments where most of the people in that room I had never met yet, and I go to a lot of social events in the Shire, and I have never had that experience where I didn't really recognize anyone in the room. Like, that's not something that's not a normal occurrence. Normally, I know at least everyone, who to talk to, who not to talk to. But I know, like, in this situation, I'm like, I keep turning around, like, I don't know who that is. I don't know who that is. Who is this? Oh, that person, I watched their move on Facebook. And by the way, if you are if you are going to move here, please post about it on Facebook or any social media.
Yeah.
Like, take photos. Like,
even if you don't like to be public, you can didn't get the help. Like, moving is a shithole. Like, ask Tila. Like, at her new movers party, like, that would have been shitty if it was just you and your dad moving stuff of flights of stairs.
Three floors,
You have so many people are like, yes, let me help you. Like,
I got unloaded in half an hour. The whole truck was unloaded in half an hour. That was how epic it was.
How many people were there?
There was like, oh, God. 2, 4, 6, 7, or 8, I want to say.
Yeah, about 7 or 8.
That's still
maybe
a decent amount of people and moving stuff.
Yeah, no, it was a good amount of people. And after, we were rewarded by the Oh My Gods, and we went skinny dipping in a pool. Except me, because I was my stupid shithead job, which I quit now. So fuck that. Let's go skinny dipping sometime soon before it gets too cold. And just get it's already too cold.
Isn't it amazing how like every time we do something, like karma rewards us with like cool shit? Like that just seems to happen to us all the time. If we set off and do something or go do this or do that or you know go help out somewhere somehow or another. Life swings us back around. A nice little surprise.
I think that's the beauty of being a new mover. Like, Tila, can you, like, comment on that? Because you've said every time I've seen you since you moved here, my life is, like, so busy. Like, there's something on my social calendar compared to when you were in Vermont.
Oh, my God. My life, like I said, Rob said I've been here for, like, a shire year, so almost 3 months. And I can't even recognize myself from being in Vermont. Like, I've only been here for 3 months, but it's crazy. Yeah. And there's always something to do. Like, I have, like, 5 Facebook events and all the time. And I'm actually running to the problem right now where I'm, like, running myself into the ground a little bit. And I have to be like, I need to take a day.
Yeah, you need a 2-day.
Sound like me from a year ago. Like, to be perfectly honest. Sound a lot like me from. I completely understand what you mean. I've gotten to a point now where literally still don't recognize myself in the mirror. And I didn't recognize myself in the mirror a year ago.
I'm much hotter.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if that's possible.
I'm not actually. First off, we have changed. If you go back and look at photos of us from just a year ago, like we don't look anything like we do now.
When I met you, I had dyed my hair jet black.
Yeah, you had black hair and it was like shoulder length.
Yeah.
And like really super straight.
I had just shaved because I quit my job and was looking for work. I actually got hired while I was at Keenvention last year.
Wow! So a couple Keenvention miracles.
Yeah. Well, I got hired prior to. I got hired, but I was waiting for the quote unquote drug test to go through.
Right. We were like sitting waiting, going, "Oh my god!"
And I got the call like while I was at Keenvention, like yes. She got the job. It was right before we got back together, too. Yeah. It was like multiple things back to back.
That's awesome.
Even like my social circles, because like I was friends with Tila, but I was also friends with a few more people that I'm not friends with anymore. And I think, you know, that's definitely for the best. Because
you have to know who to who not to trust and who to trust.
Yeah. And who doesn't.
And who sticks around. And also, like, you know, avoid and. I've gotten really good at my avoiding skills. Met a lot of really cool people as
I met a lot of great people that I consider like friends now. Me and Tila actually were friends way before me and Renee.
That's true.
So that's crazy. I remember me and Renee met at Keenvention.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. I forget that happened.
Yeah, we met at Keenvention and I gave her beer.
You know, the other day.
Underage.
The other day I showed her a picture of me, you, and Renee from that dance party. Of like all in our costumes and whatnot, and it was so weird because all of us just
Renee
so different.
Was a mermaid. You were Indiana Jones, Temple of the State.
No, Indiana Jones and Temple of the State. Yes.
Is that what you were?
Yes,
it looked a put together costume with a cowboy.
It was a very. That was not a cowboy hat. That was an Indiana Jones hat.
Oh.
All right. And I had the whole thing down. I mean, I had the chest hair out. I had the leather jacket on.
Just be lucky that you had me to keep you fashionable and nice costume.
First off, what are you talking about? I'm the one that keeps you up and level. All right. You got to keep up with me, babe.
Whatevs. All right. Anywho, did you even go to the party last year?
I was not at the last Keenvention, but I was at the dance party Keenvention.
Okay.
And I was a Viking, I think.
Oh, yes! I was like a Viking. You were like Anna.
I don't remember that at all.
Joan of Arc, or no.
Yeah. I didn't know you, Rob, but honestly, the first thing I ever heard about you was from Anne saying he is an asshole. So
I think I remember actually meeting you one time at the Quill.
Oh, that was before
Keenvention.
You know, I'm really glad you said that because I think you were with Anne.
No, that was when we were broken up.
He wasn't with me, and I was telling you even more of how much of a dick.
Yeah.
No, that wasn't before Keenvention.
But you're sitting on the couch with, I'm not going to name names.
But you were with some girl though, right?
Yeah.
He was with somebody else.
Who was I with?
Yeah, that was after.
I know that girl.
Yeah, and then I was like, yeah, asshole.
Yeah, you got to be more specific on which girl
right. In
that regards. But even then, yes, I probably was with someone at that time. I don't know. But I vaguely remember.
Yeah,
we were introduced or something. I don't know.
Probably.
But I do remember seeing it. But
his head was too big back then. He can't remember.
Couldn't even.
It's not that.
Anyway, so, I mean, yeah. So I feel like I've made such triumphs since then. And I was a college student then. Now I'm unemployed, I guess.
Going up in the world, guys.
I know. I feel like I've moved up in the world. And I feel like I'm taking more chances on myself. And I want to, like, bet on myself and see where it goes. So I feel like that's great. And I feel like last year I was taking a chance the same way by going to Keenvention and trying to stay in this community, even though I had broke up with this guy and I didn't want to be forever known as this guy's ex. And I still wanted to be a part of this community.
People don't remember that.
And then
far
I
back.
Hooked up with that guy. And now we're getting married.
Yeah. I think that might have been your diabolical plan, was to get back with me at that dance party. You didn't want me to know about it.
That was absolutely not my plan.
Yeah, that just cool happened. If it was. I think that just happened.
It wasn't your plan. Like, I did not like you. I was telling everyone how much of an asshole.
Trust me,
you were.
I can verify that.
So many people came up to me and said how you're talking shit about me left and right. I didn't.
He broke up with me over the phone. I did not do that.
Yeah, because you lived 2 hours away. I didn't feel like driving all the way down there. Just drive all the way back. That's a long. It's not like I'm driving down the street. I mean, that was an hour and a half drive one way.
He broke up with me before Pumpkin Festival, and then the riot happened. That's all I'm saying.
We'll be back with more how I just keep pissing Anne off.
Uber activism and naked saunas.
Yes, naked saunas coming up.
Sauna karma.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah, she will too.
Shop online at rrbi.co. November 11th, and Roberts & Roberts will give all the profit of every sale to antiwar.com. Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Roberts & Roberts has been your trusted source for precious metals for nearly 40 years. And we're anti-war and pro-free market. Banks drive war. Why use their money? By investing in silver, gold, and Bitcoin, you're exiting the corrupt
system. Speaking of changes, I just remember from Liberty Forum, you had like short blue hair.
Oh, yeah.
Like that wasn't even a year ago.
That's rrbi.co. Wow. Right? And our toll free number is 800-874-9760.
Wow. Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Government's murdering people around the world.
Stop. I think you look cute. Money.
There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, I love how like we had political currency.
We still have pictures Bitcoin of our first convention and Liberty Forum. Yeah. Did we get any Pork Fest? Stop. I don't know if we.
I will. This is what I'm telling you, Tila.
I was not around.
You need to not vent next year and just hang out with us like most of the time.
I'm gonna.
Like, we would come over to say hi to you and you're like, oh, I'm working. Yeah.
I came to your town all the time. I was a Tila groupie. I came here all the time.
Well,
I wanted to give you all my business.
I know. Yeah. I think I'm going to vend, but I'm going to do it like a lot less stressful. Like, I'm just going to bake what I bake, and then when I run out, I run out. I'm not going to like go home at all like I did last week, last time, and not worry so much about it.
Make sure you get $5 a month.
It was, yeah.
But did you make good money?
I hadn't made enough money to pay for my tickets and my campsite, and I bought a gun. So it was worth it. So that's why I'm, you know, I kind of want at least to cover like costs of Pork Fest so that it's not like a loss. Yeah.
It depends on how vending is this year, though. Because you don't know who's organizing. I heard it was, like, not great.
It was kind of awful.
From you, and you didn't even get your deposit.
No.
So I hope they're counting that for next year.
I don't know. I hope so.
It's fucked up. So many of the vendors were pissed off about. You're not the only vendor to say that.
I've heard all the vendors I've talked to.
Yeah, every vendor I've talked to. It scares me about this upcoming ForkFest that there's going to be people that won't vend because of it. Like, it is a worry.
And all the vendor fees and all this stuff.
It was ridiculous. It was like $200 jump from the previous year. And I was like, where's all this money? Like, I don't know. It was kind of crazy. I'd like to vend again. I'd have to talk to my dad and see what he's feeling.
Why do you want to vend?
Because money, because then I'll pay for the cost. So it's not like
I'm. Is this a long commercial break?
Yeah, this is long. We got 6 minutes. Hey, open the door.
Yeah, please open the door.
The Pentagon continues to maintain that the attack was some sort of it's like you can't get to that. Yeah, subsequently a war crime. The Pentagon said shortly after the attacks that they intend to pay for the repairs. Yeah, there's no way you can get to it. Condolence payments to the families of slain civilians. The Pentagon also promised to pay for additional repairs. The lighting. Smashing the hospital with an it's not there for the sound. I did that so you can record at any time during the day or night. For those listening at home, behind that the anarcho-capitalist Gadsden flag that I bought with Bitcoin like 4 years ago for like I don't even want to say how much Bitcoin I spent on it. All right, because I look at that flag and I just see that was like a $600 flag when it really wasn't at the time. At any rate, underneath that flag there's a window, but trying using the green screen in natural daylight is horrible, so I basically have shut it off and put like black curtain over it, just so that there's no light coming through there. That's why it's on there. She doesn't know what the struggle is building the studio. She didn't lift a finger to help this to build the studio or put up these lights and stuff like that. There's a purpose for all of it. Yeah. Doing professional lighting and chroma keying is not easy.
Yeah, I mean, this is a great studio setup.
Thank you. I still got
step up from your old place.
Right. Yeah. And the last place was cool too to begin with.
It was really cool.
Yeah.
But I like this as its own like dedicated room.
I kind of wish the room was bigger though. That's my
only
thing.
Yeah, it is a little tight.
If it was up to me, it'd be another like 4 feet wide, and I'd actually have about. I would love to have it wider so I can have. I miss having a casting couch.
Yeah.
I really miss the casting couch, and she sold my casting couch. I don't know.
It's like an icon.
It's like getting into the car that she had sex in for the first time. You know, like. Yeah, but babe, you graduated off of the casting couch. Oh, that's right. You did give it away.
She didn't even sell it. We could sell the thing on, like, you know, wait until you get really famous and then sell it on eBay. Be like, this is the Rebel Love Show's casting couch.
We're never going to get that famous. Oh, that's not going to happen.
So, yeah. You can talk and dream, right?
That's true. You know, speaking of, I actually have someone, Anne doesn't even know this yet. I actually have someone from, this woman I've been talking to on Tinder for the last 2 days. She's supposedly watching, or was watching.
Ooh.
Whether she still is or not, I don't know. But she said she was going to watch tonight. Oh, that woman I was talking to on Tinder, she says she was going to watch tonight.
That's exciting. I never have the patience for dating sites. There's too much all at once.
Jesus, Tila, you don't really need to try.
Yeah, exactly. I kind of shut all of my sites down because I was like, I don't even have time for the people I want to hang out with, so. A Republican security hawk who
told Reuters last week that he anticipated leftover food from the other day, from yesterday. Are you eating dinner for the first time now? Congress passed legislation earlier. You have a weird like appetite schedule. Like she doesn't do breakfast, period.
And if she does,
yeah.
I kind of do that. I don't like to eat early in the morning. I get hungry as the day goes on. Especially in the middle of the night. Oh, my God. So hungry.
And I ate a lot of nuts today.
All right. So do you want to come back with the Uber stuff, or we should come back more about Tila? I think we should go back to Tila. Open up with Tila. Just, I don't know, just how you've been. How are you different? You know, we kind of talked about how you don't recognize yourself, but how? And I do want to go into Polly. This is a Polly show, after all.
This is a Polly show. Let's talk about Polly.
You can tell your first, like, what happened at convention to open up your sexual horizons. And then you went like wild. You had your wild streak and then you started doing all these illegal drugs and kissing girls and guys. And
I don't know how much detail I really want to go into.
Is your dad watching at home?
No, he's actually not home. Okay. Which actually
does he watch this show?
Not normally.
Not normally.
But if
he's not
he
a fan,
knew,
huh?
He's not.
I understand.
He's like a he's like an intellectual.
Yeah,
you know?
I know. We're on an intellectual show.
And actually, if he knew that I was on, he'd probably be watching. But I don't even think I told him. I can't believe I forgot. I was talking to my parents earlier tonight, and I just.
It's okay. You're ashamed to be associated with like the dirty hippies of the movement.
Well,
I understand.
It's my parents, okay? There's a special little realm for the parents. They need
to
be protected.
Yeah, but your dad's an anarchist, anyways. It's not like he should be okay with everything.
He should be, but I'm still his little girl. So.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And before the break, we were talking to Taylor kind of about our lives, how it's changed, and just the not just the last Shire year, but the entire past year of our lives, how we don't recognize each other in the mirrors. And I kind of want Taylor to kind of go more into detail, like kind of describe yourself, what it was like before even Keenvention, like before really coming around, like the Free State Project and stuff like that. And that's another thing we never even don't ever really talk about much. We're all signers and early movers for the Free State Project. So it definitely adds a different level to what most people are or do and whatnot.
We actually signed Tila.
Yeah.
That's right.
It was like
3 days.
It was like 3 days before I moved. I just like hadn't got. And I decided to move like months ahead of time, and I was just like forgot to sign. And they're like, Ann and Rob's like, you have to sign before you move. Like you're moving in 3 days, okay? Come down here and sign.
Yeah, you have. Like it pisses me off when you get like some of these, and you're not one of them, but one of those higher than thou anarchists or libertarians. Where I don't want to sign a piece of paper saying I'm going to do something. I'll just go there and live there, which is cool. If still do that, I'm not saying not do that, but. Signing the intent definitely helps trigger the
move.
Yeah, it's
and not
more
like
more
we're
people
giving
will
that
move.
To the state.
And on top
and
of that,
saying, hey, government, look at all these people.
On top of that, yeah, it is minarchist, all right? And a lot of the stuff that like that yeah. FSP promotes is minarchist in essence, but this, in the grand scheme of things, give them 6 months once they get here. They're going to be around us. Like that will swing them around. I'd rather have them a bunch of like pro-liberty minarchists come than none at all.
That's true.
So, yes, yeah, sign the goddamn intent to move. This is my little rant when I get. I've had a couple of those rants.
Do you
with some
think you could
online.
Get any of your friends from to move?
You know,
pagan friends.
I've gotten one pagan friend to move. She wasn't from Vermont. That was. I don't know if move. I
she
think
signed.
I don't even know.
Oh. Get her to sign.
That's the first.
She's
that's
already moved. But
oh really?
Yeah.
I
don't know. Well, like I said,
she could have been at 20,000.
I don't know.
She needs to like register so they can count that in the numbers. It's all about numbers, people.
Yeah.
But I had a few like libertarian. They're kind of like minarchist friends in Vermont. I kept being like, I'm in New Hampshire. You should move to New Hampshire. And most of them are like, actually, all of them like wanted to. But like, you know, oh, I have a girlfriend up here or a family here or like, you know, they're just they're stuck and they couldn't
you
move.
Should, when people say I have I'm always it's like when you leave, your home's not going to like disappear. It's not going to just like vanish. Like, you know, you can leave and then come back to that same place and everyone you know will still be there.
I think it was mostly like girlfriends. You know, the
girl. There are people like that who are like, you know, I want to leave. Here, I had a friend who her boyfriend wanted her to move to Maine, and I'm like, all right, go.
Well,
you're not
I mean,
doing
one, move more.
Yeah.
One thing here that
you're
people
starting your life. Why
need
not?
To know, this is the divorce state project.
It, it is.
In all honesty, if you're into it and they're not,
just get divorced.
Get divorced. Get divorced.
Or you can move
do the
back
breakup.
Across the state with them and try to make it work.
Well, the thing is, even if they are a couple when they get here, even then, they're still probably going to break up.
Yeah.
Like, most couples that make it here almost always break up.
Everyone
so.
I've talked to, they're always like, I moved such and such,
what are you,
and now
what
we're
is,
not together.
What are me and Rob's chances?
Well, see, here's the thing.
Well, we had a great chance.
Great chance. Well, yeah, I was going to say you were like interested even when like you guys broke up, you were still interested in like this community. So, yeah. I think you're both on board.
Yeah.
So
that's a really lot. I mean, I can't even date a girl or a guy. It's hard for me to be attracted to anything. It's just so mainstream.
Yeah, they're so boring.
Jesus, really? This is what you think about on day-to-day life? It's like dating a robot. Yeah. Like, I don't know. I can't. It's hard for me to, like, be physically attracted to this muggle. And unless they're halfway.
Right. if they have a chance.
They can be a muggle, but at the same time, like, they gotta like show like some sort of creativity.
No, when I met Shelby, so I think I said her name.
Yeah, you did. Oh my god, doesn't matter. Anyways.
When I met this girl that I know, I was telling her about the Free State Project and I was telling her what it was and I hadn't moved yet. And then she showed up to Porkfest and she still hadn't moved, but like she was interested enough to like go find out about it. And I thought that made her so attractive. And now like she's just like down the rabbit hole completely and just like so fucking anarchist. And it's great. And I think those kind of chicks are hot and make me climax. But like some basic mediocre bitch who's sharing like firefighter fundraisers, like that's can't one of the, suck a dick. I don't know.
What's one of the reasons I deleted like my dating apps? Like everybody I met on there was just so mean and boring, and I was just like, I can't even.
All right, I want to jump in. I am known in this neck of the woods as being the 10 activist. I love the fact I'm calling Stephanie Murphy. Calling me out, I was like, oh, his favorite app on the tech panel at Keenvention is Tinder. Blah blah blah. You know, I love the fact that you listen to the show so much that you know that I talk about it. But at any rate, Tinder activism. This is a shining example of Tinder activism. She would not be in the community making a change for the world to be a better place or all that jazz and get it quoted in, you know, every newspaper under the sun and even like, you know, Maxim talking about your boobs.
I feel like
that wouldn't be happening.
I just feel
if
like
it wasn't for Tinder.
We were super lucky. I don't think it would. Because I went on a lot of Tinder dates before. Yeah. Like, a lot. Like, let me tell you. Like, I could write a book.
I don't really want. Well, I guess you I have to. I keep learning all these new experiences all the time. Like, you keep opening up things I never knew about.
Anyway, I went on a lot of Tinder dates before, and none of them were just, like, that good. None of them were like, yeah, I want that person to call me. Like, it was just all, like, perfect. I don't know. And then even after we got engaged, like. Yeah. There are like double rainbows. And I'm like, that's so weird. It's almost like perfect.
Yeah.
And then we're looking for a house and we didn't get a house. And then someone said, hey, here's this 3-bedroom apartment.
No. We found it on Craigslist. And they accept Bitcoin. And we like, got it that night.
Yeah. And we got it that same night. And I was like, that's just perfect. So I don't know. I feel like it's a luck of the draw, maybe, that we found each other. And we're both super like into whatever.
I feel like you have to sort through all the bad, you know, to get to good with anything.
You kiss a lot of frogs and then you find your prince.
Exactly. I just don't have the time with that right now.
No, like I definitely wasn't even trying to find a prince though. I feel like that's what it came down to. I was trying to find someone who wasn't sweating me that much and like letting me do my own thing because I was trying to search for this kind of individual liberation. And I think Rob really, when I swiped on him, he really helped me do that. Like even he let me listen to him. And it was really after Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree, which I'll say this until I die, you know, that it kind of just summed it all up for me. Oh my god, like,
and who showed you
I took
that?
A peel
who
like,
showed you that video?
You didn't show it to me, you sent me the link.
I told you to see it. I was gonna watch it again. I see it like 4 times. I didn't need to watch it.
No, I'll
that's something
that
you need to watch on your own
over and over and over again.
I've seen it like 3 or 4 times.
Oh, that's so crazy. Yeah, it's one of those movies you just want to watch again and again.
Teela, you watched that movie multiple times.
Yes.
Did you meet Derek J before or after?
After
it?
I watched the movie. Derek J was like this kind of celebrity, and I met him. Like, I think the first time I talked to him, it was at the Halloween dance a year ago. And he was Marilyn Monroe. And he comes up to me and goes, girl, you have such great dance moves. You're awesome. Who are you? And I was just like, this is Derek. I was just like, oh, and I couldn't, you know, you can't do the, oh, I already know who you are, Derek. You know, that's just awkward. But I was just like, oh, I'm Teela. Who are you? Oh, cool.
The last people to sit on that side of the table was Derek J
and
his boyfriend.
I was
Steven.
Total opposite. I had an orgasm. I was like, oh, my God, you're Derek.
I wish
oh
for
God.
The
audience.
I
you
wish
did my life
so
oh, my God.
That I captured that moment. I still wish I took. I didn't want. We're still in the relationship.
We're still new
in the relationship, and I didn't feel comfortable enough to record something like embarrassing as that was at the time. But
it wasn't embarrassing. Whatever.
Oh, babe.
It was embarrassing.
Yeah, it was embarrassing.
But it was embarrassing. Now that like I know him so well, and like I consider him like a close friend, like he's gonna be at my wedding party, our wedding party.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Sorry, I'm learning. He's gonna be in our wedding party, and you know he's just a close friend.
He's great.
Yeah, he's found like an awesome partner, and I love Steven. And I just like that, I came far from that fangasm to like co-hosting a show with him. It's amazing.
That's true.
How far life can go.
You've come far, far distance, babe. All right, we'll be back with more How We Change and How Much We Love Derek J when we get back from these commercial breaks. Yeah, he's been biting it lately.
Like the metal
yeah.
No,
he'll just like lock
desperate to find the medicine he needs, he discovers a
community of. Hey, can you pour me more liquor? Or can I have that drink? Because my mouth's a little.
Or will he discover that school bites? Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read
reviews
on Amazon, and read chapter 1 at survivormax.com.
An alarming UN report on magical realism released this week warns of increased incidences of women's tears flooding the entire world. A UN committee links the catastrophic phenomena to matronly widows, commonly named Tita and Edmeralda.
Good show so far.
Yeah.
We haven't gone into.
We haven't gone far.
Anything.
We're already halfway mark.
Wait. We're at 11:16. We got.
When we come back, we'll
we have three more segments left. No, three more or two more.
After this segment,
three more. Three more. There's four segments. There's four. No, there's four per hour. There's four per hour. There's three more segments.
Well, when it comes back, it'll be two.
Yeah.
So we need to cover Uber activism, right?
Let's hit the Uber activism, and then we'll swing up into you and polyamory and all that fun jazz.
God, 2 hours goes by so quick.
Right?
This is crazy.
FM is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm.
Hey, so what's going on?
In Nashua, I've been there actually. Super good sushi.
So what's going on with Seditious Sirens 2.0?
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to...
So you think there won't be a Keenvention 4?
I want there to be a Keenvention 4. I'm a little unsure. I mean, just this past...
There weren't that many people there.
There weren't that many people there.
There was less than there was the year
and
before.
And the panels were all right. And I actually, I brought a couple friends, and they were like, I'm not coming back. They were like, I mean, they enjoyed themselves because of the social aspect, but the actual panels wasn't worth it.
No, I hear you.
So, I don't know.
It was a little...
I feel like parties.
Right. I, to be honest, like, that's...
How did I tell
no. See, like, for me, I'm the exact same way. Like, Liberty Forum, last Liberty Forum, I went to any of the talks.
Right,
the only talks I went to are the ones that I was doing.
Yep.
And that was it. Other than that, like, I record way too many shows. I'm only doing one this year. Just doing one episode. That's it. And
yeah.
No talks. I don't think I'm ever going to do a talk again. I'll be honest. I guess I'll be on a panel, but I'm never going to organize a talk or a panel again.
Yeah.
I hate doing that shit.
Oh, my God. We shouldn't even talk about your panel. We should.
Hmm?
Your panel.
My panel?
Yeah. I feel
from
like
last Liberty Forum?
No, at this convention.
The one I organized?
Yeah.
I did a horrible job.
No, I don't feel like you did a horrible job. I feel like you had good questions. I feel like people weren't answering.
No one wanted to talk.
Yeah.
Like,
and
literally,
like,
no one wanted
I'll say
to
this
talk.
In the short answer to this question. I'm like, that, it's a
why
panel.
Would you give a short answer?
Why would you,
answer?
Like, why
be
would that
talkative?
Be first,
tell a story. Like I would tell,
yeah.
Like, whenever someone asked me a question, I would, like, go on a little, like, tirade. Like, oh, like, for example, this one time or this da 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 da, you know?
Yeah, they were just like, oh, this is the short answer community.
Yeah.
And then I'd just be quiet. I'm like, what?
Like,
like, what kind of, like, yeah, seriously. I was so pissed off. I ended that panel at, like, literally a Exactly hour. It's an hour and a half panel. I ended at an hour. I'm like, fuck.
Yeah. I mean, people came up and asked questions, and I was like, is it never gonna end? Not your. And welcome back to the Rebel Up Show, where we got Rob bitchin' on the microphone.
That was not
two.
On the mic, because I had that muted when I was doing that bitchin', babe.
Anywho, so I don't know if we, I think we went to Shire Sharing, and we went into
Shire
Sharing was not
okay,
talked
we
about.
Didn't talk about Shire Sharing, but this is another thing that's coming up. Are you going to do Shire Sharing this year?
When is it? If I'm free, then yes.
It would it be like 2 weeks before Thanksgiving?
No.
Oh,
no,
that's
no,
like
no,
Thanksgiving?
No, no, no.
Next week?
It is going to be the Saturday and Sunday of November 21st and 22nd.
Yeah, so the weekend before Thanksgiving.
22nd I work, the 21st I might have off.
Yeah, the 21st is the time when it's the not the collection, but that's when they're putting everything together, so... they have space rented to them for free. I forget who donated it, but it's a huge warehouse near the Manchi Airport. That's like where the that's where all the packing is going to take place. Hopefully, I know Amanda was telling me that they're close to 300 families now paid to are already paid to pay for that all the dinners. They want to reach 500. There's only 12 days left, so if you want to donate to a voluntarist charity where you see a bunch of anarchists getting together and promoting, like, taking care of, your neighbors, where we're not just selfish people, go donate to Shire Sharing. They do take Bitcoin, and they will take their Bitcoin. I actually donated some Bitcoin earlier today.
I feel we've actually donated a lot to Shire Sharing.
Yeah, we have.
But, I mean, well-deserved. We helped last year. I didn't come help organize. They were organizing some last-minute bags by the time I got there. But we actually had a whole bus, and Facebook actually was there to document for Facebook stories, and they followed us to these people's houses, and we were knocking on their door, and we'd deliver them groceries, and Amanda's policy is if they don't answer the door, just leave it there, because if someone else takes it, they might need it too. So it's just a totally selfless act. And we went there, and we were delivering the bags and knocking on people's doors, and we just got their great reactions, and they were super happy, and that was an amazing feeling. So this year, I can only imagine it's going to be that great, and I have no problem donating to it. Like, they've had
it's
many
a great charity to
fundraisers,
donate to.
And I'm just like, yes, let's do it.
Yeah, it's a fantastic charity. Please go donate. But they had the day after the New Movers Party. This is one thing with, I don't know if wherever you live, if there's a Liberty event literally day after day,
day
after
day,
day
after
day.
Like, did you have to be like, no, I have to stand you up.
I have to
I'm
stand
not
you
going.
Up
I'm taking
need,
a nap.
Yep, exactly. You have to do that sometimes.
So, like, literally the very next day after the New Movers Party, where there's 100-some libertarians, there's another about 100-some libertarians at Murphy's Tap Room, maybe like 60. I don't know if it was 100, but there's a shit ton of them there. So Shire Sharing had a fundraising event where they had a bunch of stand-up comedics doing their bits, and there was a raffle. We donated some stuff to the raffle, comics. and you can buy raffle tickets or just simply donate money there. And
okay,
that
can
was
I say
event.
The comics sucked?
Yeah.
Except for this one guy who was talking about weed.
There was a moment where the last comic, I ended up booing.
Oh my God. So they didn't know their audience, first of all. You would think if you're doing a comedy show, you're like, who is this comedy for? Oh, it's what charity? Oh, this charity. Okay. So they came there talking about supporting the troops, and it's like, let's give it up for our brothers overseas.
I know. And
everyone said anything.
It was crickets. Crickets. And then I wanted to see where this comedic would go, so I just start booing him again when he said the troops again. I start booing. I was like, boo.
And he's like, you're booing the troops?
I was
you're
like,
booing
I
war,
was like,
dude?
and then he starts going like, let's root. Like, I hope ISIS wins or something like that. Or
right.
Like, it was hilarious. But.
And then he said, okay, well, I guess that ruins the rest of my bit, because then he didn't really have anything else to
talk
about.
God.
Yeah.
What? That's awful.
No, from my perspective, though, and I've never, like, I've been to some comedy shows, and I have never gone on after the comedian, you know, stand-up comedy guy. I've never done that before. I've never been that guy, but it was, like, decades of, like, going down the rabbit hole and, like, being here and just, like, hating the military so much when... And whatever someone says, let's thank the troops, so show support for the troops and stuff like that. Normally, what do? We bite our tongue. We just don't say anything in social situations at work or whatever. We just, you know, like my job, I literally have to give a discount to people who were, you know, a military discount and shit. I hate doing that. And it was just this pent up, like, amount of, not rage, just finally I'm like, no. I don't support the people that would be used to kidnap everyone here if shit really hit the fan, stuff like that. And like, no, these people work for our oppressors. They are not heroes. And
they're not. I mean, when did killing people make you a hero?
Yeah.
They defend our freedoms anyways. They go kill people on the other side.
They're agents of state, and you can't say that you don't know someone who's in the military, because we both know someone who went. Military, and you can yourself have said you consider him a good guy.
Yeah, I mean, I know some ex-military. Yeah,
I know, I'm so pissed.
Well, no, when they're ex, that's
they're
fine.
Ex-military, and they're really decent. And most of the ex-military I know are like, I can't believe I did that.
Okay,
like,
yeah, no, that's very true. That
this
is
guy
true.
We know who was going to the army. Like we kind of met him on this path. He was hanging out with a bunch of other activists. But he went to the military, and, you know, his reason was just, like, what else was he supposed to do? That's all they taught him in school. That's
either
the only,
college or military.
College or military. That's the only way you get out of this town. Yep. And so he took the military. And, you know, why we can, you know, say to him, like, you know, like, you really understand what you're doing here? Like, he can say, no, I don't, you know. Like, I understand why you guys have something against it, but I don't really know what I'm doing. I just know this is the way out. So, I mean, he's going to have to murder people. And I'm just like, one day that's going to be your job. Like, I just hope that you're ready for that. Like, and Rob actually asked him, would you kill someone?
Yeah.
Would you just kill someone, but on command?
Oh, I remember.
Because someone commanded you to do that.
I remember one time he came into the studio, like, the first times I really got to talk to him. And he had, like, some sort of American flag, like, decal on his hat or, I don't know, something. I looked him dead in the eye, like, you do realize you're representing the enemy here, right? Like, that you're representing my oppressor. You know, I'm a secessionist. I'm an anarchist. I'm like, you're representing the thing that is in between me and freedom.
Yeah.
And it's sad that someone was in the community, like, brought around and still decided to go.
But it's like you said, you know, he's a great guy.
Oh,
he was
a great guy. He was really nice. I'm not knocking the guy. Personally, he was a great guy.
Yeah, personally, he's a great guy, very naive. And, you know, I saw that those things in his personality that are, like, hindering him from, like, falling down that rabbit hole, even though we can bring him around this and we can show it to him. Like Ron Paul said, when you see freedom, like, who wouldn't want to be free? Like, what kind of question is that? Like, everyone. So, I mean, he at the end of the day made a decision to do that, and it was a decision based off his surroundings, what he grew up hearing, and that was stronger than what he was actually physically seeing.
Social conditioning is stronger than logic. It's crazy.
Well, we're gonna tell you about our Uber activism, we promise, when we come back.
It's juicy, fuck.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a back.
The government has no more to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadadi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Oh, is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, the Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service, and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you
need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation... JK, LOL. JK, LOL, BT Dubs. It's hard to keep up with you whippersnappers with all those Zima hula hoops and Pac-Man video games. It's like you guys have attention spans that can only be measured in nanoseconds.
So what are you doing tonight? Who are you doing tonight?
No, and I'm going home and sleeping. I've got plans tomorrow.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Going out to eat.
Ooh. Romantic.
I'm pretty excited.
I should like write him and be like, this is the wine you should order if you really want to get lucky.
I don't think that's an issue. I don't know. I feel like I have plans for Thursday.
We're going down to Boston Thursday.
Nice. Friday night, I've got plans. Saturday night, I've got plans.
Yeah, here.
Here, I have plans, yeah. Yeah. But I thought I had something to do on Thursday, and I can't remember, which means, oops.
Maybe you had a free Thursday.
Yeah, I think that's what it was, is I needed the night to myself. That's right.
You should, like, just take a day out.
I needed that, yeah. So I did today. Canceled on someone to.
You canceled on someone today?
Yeah, just to go home and do shit.
Damn.
I was a disaster. Let's see. Last night I had a date and I just was not. I was so tired. I was like, you know, passed out early.
I should go out on more dates. Yes, I agree. I should. My thing is, I don't know. That's a lot to take me away from me next year. I'm not trying to be needy. I do plan. I'll have another date lined up. I'm talking to a couple women right now. Yeah. What? You should do you, babe. You want to go on more dates? Go on more dates. I think you're encouraging me because you get tired of me being around so much.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. I was telling my fiance over here how he should go on more dates.
I should.
So I could have more and time. Just kidding. I love seeing him all the time. But no, I think you should go on more dates. Like,
I'll see what I can do. I got a few prospects out there right now.
I think polyamory is the new hot topic.
You know what's weird about polyamory? It's not weird to like that polyamory is a thing that where we talk about it or anything along those lines. It's more so the simple fact that, like, it feels so normal to me. Like, this feels like a normal life. Like, the fact that, like, I see some of your boyfriends more naked than you do, Tila, just seems like a normal thing in the Shire.
Which leads us to Uber activism. Okay.
We'll circle back eventually.
Tarantino that shit.
So what happened with Chris David?
Christopher David. All right, we'll jump in. We only got 2 segments left here or so, give or take. So yeah, we need to talk about the Uber activism that happened in Portsmouth. All right, so let me do the Reader's Digest version here. Christopher David is he's been in the Shire for over a year now. I actually remember meeting him over a year ago when he was like working for, I don't even want to, He was a politico. He was a huge politico.
Like some super PAC.
Andrew Hemingway was dating Rob's ex. Yes. She actually made her go mono at one point. At any rate.
In the entire universe. Okay. Slut. Okay.
I know. People on the internet know this too. It's okay. Anyways, that was a weird time in my life. That's not what this segment's about. The segment is dedicated to Christopher David.
who has a lovely fiance and a baby on the way.
Any day now. So, anyways, his life somehow got him out to Dover and Portsmouth and all that jazz. And he became an Uber driver out there. And the city of Portsmouth, not too long ago, made it completely illegal to be an Uber driver because Uber didn't follow some sort of regulation or what have you to be considered like taxi service or some bullshit, which every most laws that are victimless laws anyways, that kind of regulation telling you how to drive somewhere, what to do, or how you can interact with people is bullshit, all right? And it was to the point where like Uber just didn't follow suit. They didn't actually implement those things. You know how hard it is for them to implement every weird little tiny ordinance around every city in the entire planet? Like, there's an app on your phone, for God's sake.
Which is why a lot of people were still doing Uber in Portsmouth. Like, a lot of people are still doing
there's
Uber.
There's even a 63... The first ticket was actually issued to a 63-year-old grandma bus driver who does Uber on her like nights off and stuff like that, or like every other night just to make some extra income because her husband passed away and she wanted to get out of the house. Like, that kind of person is still doing this.
Yeah, and if you don't know where Uber is, it's basically what Rob said, an app on your phone. But also the other important thing to know about Uber, it is everywhere else.
Yeah,
every single state that you can go, it's everywhere else. I was in Boston. Uber was old fucking news. They were already making ripoffs of Uber. Like, it was old news. And now it's trying to move. It's trying to innovate. It's trying to grow. Like, Uber should be old news in Portsmouth instead of and embracing something that's just like a trend. It's new. It's hip. It's cool. It's something without a meter. It's like something less invasive. Like, if I leave my phone there, I'm going to be able to call and just get it back. Versus if I take this taxi cab who might just charge me $20 extra or leave me here in the middle of the street or pull over and rape me. I don't know. Like, shady taxi cab driver.
It's such a better application and business platform, period, business model.
Yeah.
Taxis need to start doing Uber.
I get to see this guy's picture before I say, yes, I want to get in the car.
Yep.
At any rate,
I'm just saying, that's a great app.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. Yeah, but the thing is, Portsmouth made that illegal, babe. They said no. Yeah, how dare you use an app on your phone and not use these taxi services that are paying us a lot of money to make you illegal.
Yes, and everywhere else is already like accustomed to these taxi savers. So Portsmouth made it illegal, and people are still doing it. And our friend, Christopher...
Yeah, Christopher David, he was out there. Now, he actually didn't get arrested for being an Uber driver. However,
he got the Daniel Street Tavern.
If you're ever in Portsmouth or New Hampshire in general,
flip this bar off.
Fuck
and the
that
owner.
Bar. Fuck that bouncer. Don't ever
fuck the
go
owner,
to that
she's
place.
A bitch. All right. I don't like
they
her.
Hate Uber. They
hate freedom.
Basically, the bouncer there, because one thing that we activists like to do is videotape all of our interactions wherever the fuck we are in regards to, like, you know, the police and shit like that. So there he is driving Uber at this point illegally and almost as a form of activism. Using an app on your phone became a form of activism, which is just crazy to think about in itself. It's just zeros and ones and, you know, it's just an app. You know, at any rate, he's recording his interactions being a driver for Uber, and he interacts while he's there. He gets pulled over. There's a police officer and then a bouncer from the tavern, the Daniel Street Tavern, like screaming at him, talking about how he's going to get arrested because there's, you know, pimping out the taxi service and stuff like that. Well, Christopher David uploaded that to YouTube. Like, this is what it's like being an Uber driver. Like, I'm having to deal with this stuff, like just trying to drive drunk people home safe. That guy filed a felony wiretapping charge against them in full backing of that tavern. So last Friday, the police went through, and I think Thursday or Friday they went to they issued a warrant out for Christopher David's arrest. So basically, the court system said, "All right, yeah, it's illegal for you to record you being an Uber driver. We are now going to tell someone on a piece of paper to go over to your house and kidnap you because you hit record on a phone while you're in front of police and all the world. Now, mind you, the police actually didn't do it because they learned their lesson from Carla G and where, like, you don't fucking, like, arrest activists for filming police. But this was a little bit different situation.
They definitely helped this guy escalate the charges, though. Think about it. This guy was recorded by these Uber drivers, and he just automatically said, yes, this felony wiretapping.
Yeah.
Like, no. That wasn't a thought that crossed his mind. They were wanting to escalate the charges.
Oh, yeah. They're
about control.
They're just trying to find something on him. Just do something because he was pissing him off, you know?
But the amazing thing about the because when confronted, she was like, oh, you guys are out here, like, disrespecting my bar. Like, how dare you? It wasn't my bar who did this. And I was like, well, is your bartender fired? Because you guys are calling the police on people who are driving, like, Ubers. And she's like, no, I'm not going to fire him. Taking food out of his kids' mouths. He has 3 jobs. And I'm like, freeze. So you're okay with putting someone who's about to have a baby in jail and behind bars, taking food out of his kids' mouth to protect your bouncer who has 3 jobs and gets people in jail. Like, she just could not make that distinction. And she got super pissed. Some guy was out there arguing that ISIS runs Uber. Because when we start disobeying the laws, this is how ISIS comes into play. Like, it was like that's, the most ridiculous
That's someone just trolling. Yeah. But at any rate.
No, that was a guy out there. He was not trolling. He seriously meant this. He even said, let me tell you the story. We were out there and we were arguing with this guy. He was arguing. We were mostly just trying to point some logic in his head. He was like, well, if Uber is against the law, then you shouldn't be doing it because anything that's against the law is wrong. So, of course, Andrew, you know, we're out there with all these brainiacs. He's like, what? So, slavery was legal, right? And he's like, yeah, I know. And that was horrible. My grandson was black. Is black. And then he was like, yeah, so you think that's okay, you know, for your grandson to be a slave? And he was like, if it was the law.
He said that?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
So that's just a really awful human being.
Why the state shouldn't exist.
People were out there. This is a member that goes to this bar. And, like, they were out there, like, hooping hoorahing for him. Like, you got to really see how these people are thinking. Like, literally, he was saying that. And he was saying they went to all the way down to who will build the roads with this guy.
Well,
he screamed. He was like, and I bet you guys think that we should be letting anybody across the border.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, of course we should. Like, borders are nothing more than.
That's literally what he screamed at us.
Borders keep you stupid.
Yeah,
borders
these are the people out there. These are these people.
Are nothing but imaginary lines drawn on a map by people long since dead. But somehow people still follow that. More activism in Uberland when we return. All right, we need to really talk about, like...
You missed this guy.
I know, but babe. Like, I wanted... Like, we still now have to talk about the Uber activism for the next time, because I wanted to get to the sauna story.
We're going to talk about it.
Yeah, I know, but I want to talk about polyamory with Tila.
We're not.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian.
No, we never even came to it yet.
We were trying to get to Uber activism first and then come back to the poly.
That was the whole point, but you went on like this tirade for 5 minutes about something. About the story. Yeah, I know. I'm not saying it's a tirade. I'm just saying, like, I wanted to jump to, like, the sauna story.
There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it, but here in New Hampshire, people are...
No, that's okay. It's all right.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project...
You guys are, like, already married.
ReasonsFilm.com. 101ReasonsFilm.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market.
I want to talk about the sauna story.
The Silk Road was a gift to humanity.
Just come back and say, the harms brought on by drug prohibition.
For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole.
And then I'll somehow do a hard transition because that's not going to cover anything.
It needs your support. Please visit freeRoss.org. You can contribute via methods including Bitcoin.
freeross.org. That's freeross.org.
Did you know you can listen to LRN.FM, our free-to-air satellite channels? We have channels over nearly all.
If you were there, to be perfectly honest, yes, that's a perfect transition.
I do this for a living.
There are no monthly fees. Learn more at sat.lrn.fm. Plus, if you are a broadcaster or want to be one, this is a good delivery method for our content. See our coverage maps and get details at sat.lrn.fm.
That's the metal thing.
Are you gonna pack more pot in there or not, babe?
Anyone can publish on the internet, but not everyone is publishing.
I'm not paying attention to when we're coming back.
Yeah, because I want to know when the commercial break is.
Yahoo Style Guide, it cautions that internet content has a few seconds, three or less, to encourage people
I'm
to
a little drunk.
You're a little drunk? Well, then you should drink more.
I'm a little drunk as well. I'm like a perfect amount of drunk, so I'm just going to stop
it. Oh, babe, you need to drink more, too. I like it when you get just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Not all the way.
I want to be cohesive. I just know being on such a Sirens at Porkfest, I was super drunk, and it was really hard for me to talk or do anything. I was just like,
Same goes for your keywords.
What'd you do to it?
What someone would likely type into the search box on Yahoo or Google.
Ouch.
For more tips on communicating better online.
I was actually noticing that.
Online,
I wish I could have finished slicing it. Hit survivalspeech.com.
I don't know about that.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter,
no.
Google.
By the
you
way, though,
seen this guy, and he was your typical like fucking racist guy. Like he just had this long gray biker beard,
ew,
and like these like biker shorts. But he was like 86. Like it was like
I can't believe he was like yeah, overweight. my grandson should be a slave.
Yeah.
The like, fuck
no,
kind of moralist are you?
He was out there arguing with them for a long time after he even left.
Psycho.
And then I started arguing with the owner of the bar. Like, fucking bitch. She was a fucking bitch. She was like, he admitted he broke the law. I'm like, it's a bad law. Like, who's the victim of his crime?
I mean,
like, all your customers who are still using Uber, most of their customers, when we were, like, they wanted to talk to us. They were like, why are you guys out here? I'm like, oh, like, this. And they're like, oh, we used Uber to come out here.
Yeah.
I'm like, you know this lady called the police on your Uber driver? Like,
it's ridiculous.
Well, that's because they're in cahoots with the fucking taxis.
Yeah, they're the bouncers at cabbie.
We're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio.
Well, I mean, I love when my excuse is when someone's like, oh, it's illegal, you shouldn't do it. It's like, well, look at Nazism.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. If you are listening on LRN or IPM, make sure you go to rebelloveshow.com, click on live, and you can watch our beautiful faces as we smoke some pot and chit-chat and all that jazz. So before the break, we were talking about the Uber activism going down in Portsmouth. It's the Christopher David victimless crime spree of our day. We're watching this unfold in real life. Who knows, in 5 years from now, people will have a podcast somewhere
history.
In Portsmouth talking about, oh my God, it's the first time I met Christopher David. You know, like that's going to be a thing that happens at some point. And anyways, I made it out there late. I didn't get out there until like 10:30. Made a little video. It's
he
up
just
on YouTube.
Made it in time to get drunk and party.
That's my best kind of activism. That's activism I love.
Portsmouth. Okay, this is my last tangent. Portsmouth has some great late night food. That's all I'm gonna say.
I wish Manch looked a lot more like Portsmouth. Though I wish Manch looked a lot more like Portland too. But that's a whole other story. But anyways, afterwards, like just how we're talking about earlier about
we
how whenever
out
we
like
do
12,
act, no.
Just,
we,
no, no, 12 out there protesting.
No, no, no. There's some people out there. Then we left at like 11.
Yeah,
maybe a little early. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
At any rate,
we were at the food truck by like 1.
No, we left. We left downtown area like at 12:30. But like 12 by midnight, 12:30, we're at Eros.
Oh, okay.
Anyways, we were. I had this amazing thing. Whenever we do any kind of activism or something like that, the universe rewards us with like something cool, something you got to do. And all of a sudden, we get invited by like some other free coasters out there. But contrary to popular belief, they're actually really cool free coasters. Like when you think of a free coaster, you think of them smelling their farts in wine glasses in the Praxium. But heaven forbid, you know.
That's my joke. You suck.
That's everyone's joke, babe. Everyone has that joke about the free coasters. But I'm not trying to. At any rate, cool free coasters. We get invited to this like impromptu party, and lo and behold, there is a Swedish sauna, a traditional Swedish sauna.
First of all, it's a guy who's a pre-stater. He's a friend of Chris's, and he invites us all back for a bonfire. Is what happened.
Well, he's still a free coaster.
Yeah. No, he was a free coaster. He had been there for a while. He took a break to raise his kids. His kids are all grown up now. Yada yada yada. He has this amazing bonfire. He has
built a literal throne
that he made of wood, wooden benches. Like, it was great. It was the most beautiful bonfire I had ever seen. And he's from Finland, and he starts telling us about how every home is the tradition in Finland to have a sauna. And so he has the traditional Finnish sauna that he built to Finnish standards, so some things were illegal. And he had like a crazy like 10 watt heater or something.
So I don't know what it was, but it was incredible. Crazy. All of us just pile in butt ass naked and get into the sauna.
And it's beautiful. His home is beautiful. Like, it's great. And we started putting beer in the sauna. We get super.
And then we'd run out and we'd all be fucking naked around the bonfire sitting in these wooden huge thrones when it's like 40 degrees outside. And then we run back in. It was such a cool night.
I got super duper drunk and I like passed out naked.
Oh, you didn't get a chance to sit in the throne naked, did you, babe?
No, I didn't sit in the throne naked. I did sit outside naked, though, for a little bit. And he was just like, yes, anything goes. And I was like, this is my kind of guy.
Yeah, this was like going full mansion the coast. Like, this was awesome.
Yeah, we went full Keniac and then full man.
While being full free coaster. Like, yeah. It was
the only thing, though, it was a sausage fest.
You weren't enough women. And if Tila was there, the ratio would have been high enough to warrant an orgy.
It would have been awesome.
It would have been fantastic. Awesome,
but you weren't there, Tila.
I was sleeping. I went to bed at like 9 that night.
Wow. We came home at like 5 a.m.
You know, I still made it up for MVP. I'm impressed, actually.
Oh, my God. Like, that's something that's not even in there. That's a whole nother thing.
We'll be talking about it later on the Rebel Love Show.
No, this is the last segment.
We're not going to talk about it.
Other episodes.
There's other stuff we haven't even talked about, guys.
The MVP meetup was great. There was a lot of people there as well.
Still not enough girls,
but more girls. And we made it there. But the sauna was great. I mean, I feel like the problem in the community is there's just not enough hot.
Let me tell you something.
Polyamory would be so much easier if it was more straight. Bi women.
Well, yeah.
Every woman should be at least bi.
I agree.
I think so.
We're curious. Yes.
I think so.
I mean, I feel like I can talk most women into it.
Yeah, women are easy to talk into it. Guys have this kind of like stigma around being bi or gay or whatever. But
I don't understand why.
I kind of understand why.
Why?
I don't get it.
Why? It's a.
Why is there a double standard?
It's not. Oh, there definitely is a double standard.
And then
standard.
Talk
I
about
tell
polyamory.
I mean, the reason being is like, if answering the question why, it's just like why with anything, like someone doesn't like venture out past them. There's like a mental wall that it's hard to get yourself outside of that
I
wall
feel like
that you've
people,
been preconditioned by society no, to be in.
People
it.
Are just too worried about other people judging them, but you have to That's free true. Yourself from judgment at the same time. Yeah. Because if you worry about people judging you, you'll never do anything for you.
It's true.
And who gives a fuck? Like, no one
cares. You only
cares.
Live once. Live
you
your fucking lives.
You only live once. And, like, people only speculate. So do whatever the fuck you want to do. And people are going to be talking shit about you anyway. So you might as well have
hey,
fun.
The way I see it, the more shit and talk and haters you have, the more you're probably on the right track.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Pissing people off, you're doing something right.
Yeah. Some girl said I was a bitch.
I
was a bitch to her. I have never remembered an interaction where I was a bitch to this girl.
Yeah, there's girls who I like in the Free State Project. They meet me and hate me.
Just
I don't even
you're
know
hot,
why.
Hot, beautiful, and young, Tila. But, I mean, normal women will hate you anyways. I mean, you're in a situation where you know you have a higher percentage of the market share.
That's
because
true.
There's
I suppose.
More men
but
than
if
there
anyone's
women.
A bitch, it's Renee. So anyway, back to polyamory. I mean. Sorry, excuse me. A lot of people are saying that's the reason why you should move to the Free State Project if you're a man or a woman, because you can be polyamorous and a woman and have so many boyfriends. Yay, you. Or you can be a man and share a woman.
This is the polyamorous pansexual capital of the anarchist
the
world. Circle.
World.
Yeah, a little anarchist corner of the world.
It's, I feel like
Can you describe your poly life to us?
It's crazy.
Like yeah, in the next 2 minutes, because odds are we're probably just going to have you back on as a guest in a couple of weeks to talk about it more.
Let her talk.
Oh my God, a minute. Go ahead.
Well, yeah, I don't know. It's just I have a lot of opportunities. I am the minority, so that makes things a lot easier. I will have to admit that's kind of nice. But I've met a couple different people, a few different people, and I've been dating and just trying to live the poly life. It's definitely kind of a scheduling nightmare.
Calendar.
Yeah, are you using calendar? Because if not, you should be.
I am not, but keeping track of it okay. It's just not enough time for me.
Are you
okay? Tila, sum up your life real quick and tell the people where they can find you in Dance Academy.
Sorry. Oh yeah. Sum up my life. It's awesome. It's hectic. It's crazy. It's new every second.
But you're glad you moved.
I'm so glad I moved. You can find me at I do have SJO Dance Academy, which is up and coming. That's sjoacademy.com or sjoDanceAcademy@gmail.com. You can also find me on Facebook. Tila Schollander.
Will you just add anybody?
I actually don't. I'll keep them in. I keep them in a queue, and then when I meet them in person, then I hit the add button.
Oh my God, you are so horrible at that. I add almost everyone.
I don't add some of those crazy. An eyeball is their picture with a Confederate flag in it. Like, yeah, that's weird.
I do have a thing where unless it's. I used to add anyone, but they have to have a face picture at this point. Otherwise, I won't add them.
If their face picture is just some random person who's probably a spam bot, you should probably have
at least 50 mutual friends or I don't accept them.
Oh, okay.
That's true.
Unless I do some research into them and they actually look like a real profile. If they somehow their profile picture like piqued my interest, then I'll take a look. You know, it's like actually looking at a profile before you swipe right on Tinder, which you don't normally do. You just swipe left or right. You always look.
I want to see who they are. Mutual friends,
yes. If there's mutual friends, I will always look.
Not likes and interests, but mutual friends, that says a lot about a person.
That's true. Mutual friends does say a lot because you know whether or not they're a free stater or not.
Yeah, if it's a random free stater, is like their mutual friend, and then they're super hot, I'm like, who the hell is this person? Yeah. I'll fuck her.
Yeah,
you also have a very good idea of what that if they have all the same mutual friends in the same kind of scene, even in the Free State Project, their scenes you already kind of know like who they're connected
yeah, they're
to
kinky.
And stuff like that. Yeah, you could tell the kinksters and the non-kinksters based off the mutual friends that they have on Tinder.
Yeah, but yeah, so even like preppies for me, people I'm like, she knows him. She's a preppy. I'm not down. Yeah. But I mean, if you want to find me,
where can they find you, baby?
On the Rebel, go like the Rebel Mistress on Facebook. I got some new stuff coming out of there, and then you know, just rebelupshow.com. And I'll also be on Flaming Freedom sometime this month, so check them out.
Yeah, so go to rebelupshow.com, but make that your bookmark for God's sake. Go subscribe to us on YouTube because we are on YouTube, and make sure you download us on iTunes or Stitcher. That's pretty much it. We'll be back next week.
Peace,
guys.